Your priests, O Lord, shall be clothed with justice. Your holy ones shall ring out their joy. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Today we remember St. Anthony of Padua. We ask him to intercede for each and every one of us as we seek the Lord's mercy and compassion, and we truly acknowledge those times we have sinned.
You are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who gave St. Anthony of Padua to your people as an outstanding preacher and an intercessor in their need, grant that with his assistance, as we follow the teachings of the Christian life, we may know your help in every trial, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah set out and came upon Elisha, son of Shaphat, as he was plowing with 12 yoke of oxen. He was following the 12th. Elijah went over to him and threw his cloak over him. Elisha left the oxen, ran after Elijah, and said, "Please let me kiss my father and mother goodbye, and I will follow you." Elijah answered, "Go back. Have I done anything to you?" Elisha left him, and taking the yoke of oxen, slaughtered them. He used the plowing equipment for fuel to boil their flesh and gave it to his people to eat. Then he left and followed Elijah as his attendant. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. You are my inheritance, O Lord. You are my inheritance, O Lord. Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, "My Lord are you." O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup, you it is who hold fast my lot. You are my inheritance, O Lord. I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night my heart exhorts me. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. You are my inheritance, O Lord. Therefore my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption. You are my inheritance, O Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. Incline my heart, O God, to your decrees, and favor me with your law. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard it said to your ancestors, 'Do not take a false oath, but make good to the Lord all that you vow.' But I say to you, do not swear at all, not by heaven, for it is God's throne, nor by earth, for it is his footstool, nor by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great King. Do not swear by your head, because you cannot make a single hair white or black. Let your yes mean yes, and your no mean no. Anything more is from the evil one." The Gospel of the Lord. So today we observe and celebrate and focus our mind on Saint Anthony. Forgive me as I can't find my notes here in these pockets. Saint Anthony was born in 1195 in Lisbon, Portugal. And he was born purportedly to a wealthy family. He entered the Augustinian order at a pretty young age, and by the time he was 25, he was ordained and highly educated. Within just a few years, though, St. Anthony was struck by an event that would change the course of his life forever. Five Franciscan friars went to Morocco to preach the gospel in mosques. They were tortured and beheaded. Their bodies came back, and as they were wheeled through the town on a cart to the local monastery, St. Anthony was struck by the way that they had given the ultimate gift back to God, by the way they had paid the ultimate price to preach the gospel. St. Anthony wanted to embrace that life. He went up to the local monastery of Franciscans, and as an Augustinian, he went to the friar and said, "Brother, I would gladly put on the habit of your order if you would promise to send me as soon as possible to the land of Saracens so that I may gain the crown of the holy martyrs." After some discussion, the Franciscan order accepted him, and the Augustinian order decided to release him, that's what he wanted. And he was sent immediately on a ship to preach the gospel in the land of the Saracens. But as often happens, sometimes what we want to do in order to serve God isn't what God wants us to do to serve him. God had a different plan. St. Anthony got very sick on the way, and he had to be dropped off in a different place, Messina, Italy, where he spent some months. And then they started to ship him back to where he came from. But the ship encountered a great storm, and he wound up landing in a different place. And he was in Italy, in Sicily. And so he stayed there for some time, and he went to a Franciscan and Dominican ordination in the year 1222. No one knew St. Anthony's background. They didn't know his high level of education. They didn't know that he was a former Augustinian. They just took him for a simple kind of new guy on the block, you know, for a temporary time. And after this ordination, as they gathered for lunch, it was a little bit of a tradition for someone to be picked out from the crowd of friars and priests and for them to give a few words reflecting on the gospel that day as people ate lunch. And you can imagine how this probably happened. Everybody's sitting there. There's some, you know, pewter cups and plates clinking. Nobody's really half paying attention to, like, what somebody's saying. Some people just kind of drone on boringly. St. Anthony gets up to speak as an unknown. And within a few minutes, people realize the absolute gift that St. Anthony has for preaching. And so he is, after his great impression that he leaves, he's sent on missions to preach. He develops such a great reputation for being such a fantastic preacher that by the end of his life, 30,000 person crowds were gathering to hear him preach, to hear him speak of the gospel and preach the word of God. St. Anthony, like many others in his time period, had a lot of people that were preaching false gospels at the time, heretics. He gained the moniker Hammer of Heretics, which is often misused. It evokes this image of St. Anthony out there preaching fire and brimstone to anyone who does not, you know, believe in exactly the authentic church teaching, that he's out there shouting people down. But in reality, he got the moniker Hammer of Heretics because he converted countless people by his preaching of the gospel in a positive, attractive way, as an alternative, as a truthful, authentic alternative that drew people in by its own merits without having to shout others' opinions down. So when we hear the term Hammer of Heretics, it wasn't that St. Anthony was saying anything against others. He was so effective in preaching for the true gospel that people were attracted. At the end of his life, he received a vision of the child Jesus, which is why his statues are often pictured with him, with a small Christ child. A lily and a book is another one of his items that he's often pictured with. And so there's countless stories that I can go into, but I think they're instead, that because it's only daily mass and Father Jason is probably already thinking, my gosh, he preaches way too long. Mm-hmm. Yep. I'll just say just a few points that I think we can take away from St. Anthony's life. One is that oftentimes the way that we want to serve God isn't the way that he wants us to serve him. So we can never get too fully wrapped up in our service and put blinders on saying, I have to do this ministry. This is my ministry. This is the way that God's calling me to do this. That we always need to stop and evaluate. We always need to have an open heart. We always need to have kind of a blank slate in our prayer to say, God, show me what you want me to do. Is this where you want me to continue? Even giving back the ultimate gift, being a martyr, wasn't what God wanted to do. He had a different plan for St. Anthony. So it's not the value of our gift. God calls us to do sometimes things that are, in our mind, lesser than what we think he wants. And another, of course, lesson that we can take away from St. Anthony, especially in this time period of division, is that you attract more flies with honey rather than vinegar, or more bees with honey rather than vinegar. St. Anthony, this moniker of Hammer of Heretics, provides a great lesson in that. He converted so many people by preaching the merits of the gospel, by preaching its positive facets, and I think most importantly, because he lived the gospel. He wasn't some preacher that, you know, drove in on a Mercedes and preached prosperity and then left town. When he preached the poor, he lived poor. When he preached holy obedience, he lived holy obedience. And so by that, many people were converted. And I think that's such an important lesson for our own time period. So as you can tell, I have a passion for St. Anthony. He's my favorite saint. He's definitely been someone who's been instrumental in my family and has answered and has been an effective intercessor for many of my prayers, as for so many others. So I encourage you today to say a prayer for St. Anthony's intercession, to read a little bit about him, and to just kind of think about how we can apply the lessons of his life to our own. And may God be praised.
Relying upon God's grace, we place before him our needs, knowing he will hear and answer every one of our prayers.
That the one God in three persons may bring about unity and harmony among the many nations of the world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have been made ill by the coronavirus, for all who care for them, and for the governments and people of the world, that we may experience the healing mercy of the Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may ever more effectively proclaim Christ, who leads all to the Father in the Holy Spirit, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as the life of the Trinity fills God's people, they may, as people of life, bring about a new respect and protection of every human being's right to life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That married couples may have the wisdom and courage to support one another, helping the other to grow and develop their talents, to become all that God wants them to be, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those serving in the armed forces, in law enforcement, for emergency responders, and for those in health care, for the continued growth of peace and freedom in troubled parts of our world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to violence in our streets and a respect for all people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and suffering may be healed and the faithful departed may be granted peace and rest in Jesus Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Salvatrice Ocorso, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we ask all these things through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made, will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed upon your altar in commemoration of blessed Saint Anthony, so that as you brought him glory, you may, through these sacred mysteries, grant to us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praise has had nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to the glory of your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. He gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread. He gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of his saving passion, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her beloved spouse, your blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, with Saint Ursula, with Saint Anthony, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, William, our Archbishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your very own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. And now, at the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your divine will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter on my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Blessed is the servant whom the Lord finds watching when he comes. Amen, I say to you, he will put that servant in charge of all his property. Once again, for communion, please come by way of the side aisles and return to the pews by way of the center aisle. those who cannot receive communion at this time, I offer you this prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the Eucharist. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May, partaking at the heavenly table, Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high in all who celebrate the feast day of Blessed Saint Anthony, that we may preserve in integrity the gift of faith and walk in the path of salvation you trace for us through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.